Hi guys. Listen, a week ago I came on and I mentioned about self-preparedness, preparing for self-sufficiency. Now, since that time, I think I've came on three other times and said prepare for self-sufficiency. It's been something that's been very heavy on my heart. But check this out. So I think it was like 3 days ago I was on and I shared how we went to Sam's Club, my mom and I. And we pretty much got everything that we went for, everything that we needed. But just the other night, my associate told me that they are empty. This exact same Sam's Club that we went to, that they're empty. They don't have anything. And another associate confirmed that again today. And then I noticed the manager at a place where I had dinner at last night, she told me that they had to cut their hours because normally they're never closed on Mondays. Now they're closed on Monday and I can't remember what other days. She said they cut their hours because trying to compensate for the shortage of foods that they've not been able to get. So people of God, prepare for self-sufficiency. You know, I believe God will always warn his people, and it's not just me, it's several other people of God. Like I said, since 2018, the Lord has been showing me things in dreams, and I've been warning the people I love since then. And I myself have been taking heed and being obedient to what he's put in my spirit, and because of that, I feel pretty good, you know. I'm okay. Whatever is going on in the world, nothing's going to affect me because I've been obedient to what the Lord has put in my spirit. And several other people have said the same thing. We've had similar dreams. We've had similar visions. So God is not a man that he should lie. You know, he said, let God be true and every man be a liar, you know. He does nothing of a mystery. He reveals things to us. Not to frighten us, not to make us afraid, but to prepare us. You know, I don't think that God wants his people to be caught off guard by anything. And then not on that, our number one thing that we should be doing is standing in the scriptures, studying the word, and so that we just, you know, continue. Every day is a battle to, you know, walk according to the will of God. And we can't lose. We can't go wrong with God. When God is in the midst, you can't go wrong. So, again, prepare for self-sufficiency, stay in the Word of God, and live your life. Enjoy life. Enjoy what he's doing for you, through you, and around you. And don't let nobody make you feel bad for it. All right, have a blessed day.